What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel, where we get you on the grind and improve your mind. Today, we're going to go over law number 14 of Robert Greene's 48 Laws of Power. Let's get into it. So, law number 14 is pose as a friend and work as a spy. Knowing about your rival is critical. Use spies to gather valuable information that will keep you a step ahead. Better still, play the spy yourself. In polite social encounters, learn to probe, ask indirect questions to get people to reveal their weaknesses and intentions. There is no occasion that is not an opportunity for artful spying. So what he's saying is basically, what we say sometimes is that when you're in conversations or even when you're on a date with a girl, a business thing, or with your friends, you should let people do most of the talking. Ask a lot of questions, get information, and don't directly like use it to your advantage out loud and get everybody's attention. Just keep it to yourself, just in case.
This law works in conjunction with Law 13 in a sense, but it also is kind of like the opposite of Law 3, which is conceal your intentions. So, like, if people follow Law 3, you know, they're going to try to hold back, and so will you. And what this is trying to do is trying to make them conceal their intentions by giving them, you know, like, open-ended questions, you know, trying to have them talk more and give them whatever you need for them to, you know, give the information that you want. And so I find that very interesting that you know, a lot of these laws they're starting to form together and group together and or become opposites in a specific way, if you understand. Just watch those videos that we have on the channel in the playlist up on the cards, and then come back and you'll understand. But yeah, so this is very good for, you know, just gathering information. This is good for understanding certain, like, business deals. Like, if you're, you know, if you have, like, your own business and you're trying to get a business deal going, you know, get information about the other person and their side of the deal, what they want out of it. Try to get that out of them. If you're on a date with a woman, you know, we talk about this a lot. Don't do a lot of talking. Let them talk. Let them have them reveal a lot of their story and stuff, and take that in. It also will help to make sure that if you're on the right date, you know, honestly, because sometimes you know you look at them, they're really nice, and then you let them speak, and then they say some dumb things, and you're just like, wow, this is just awful. But you know, this is the point. Like, you want to gather this information so you understand more, and you can, you know, get the intentions revealed, and you can have your intentions, you know, find out where your intentions lie, and just either you leave that or whatever.
Yeah, you can say it's a dark law, people use it against you, but this is also human nature, and people will do this to you anyway. So yeah, it's very important to at least be aware of laws like these, so you can at least be in a good position in any interaction you may be with. It's always good to be positive when you're talking to people, ask questions, have them invest into you, and invest in the conversation. You want to get them talking, because that's one of the ways you can win people over, is generally just ask them questions and convey to them that you're interested in the conversation, and they'll tell you a bunch of information you may not have expected to know. But you could find a lot about people by doing this, using this tactic, and just asking questions and shutting up a lot of the time. Just don't talk too much, but just do let them speak. And in return, they'll feel like they know you more, because they'll be able to tell you more of their thoughts, and you can actually use it to your advantage, and it's a good way to win people and influence them as well. Just have them explain to you their thoughts, and you could actually, you know, it's a good way to make friends as well. You know, like when you're on a date with a girl, that's why it's always good to, like, let them talk and do most of the talking, ask questions, and make a couple funny jokes that way. And then, like, by the end of the date, they're like, wow, I feel like I already know you. Even though they're the ones who did most of the talking, you didn't really do anything. You just asked questions. So when a girl really says, like, oh, I just want to get to know you, you just, you know, just get to know them, and then they'll feel like they already know you, and then all you have to do. So do less talking and have them talk more, and that's how you win a girl over. That's a pro tip. Or, like, you know, when you're with friends, ask them questions, stories, and act like you're interested. You know, you should be interested.
Well, yeah, they're your friends.
But, like, you know, when it comes to anybody you're interacting with, it's always good to make friends wherever you go, because you never know when it can come in handy.
Yeah, and the thing is that you want to use this law. Granted, hopefully, you're not trying to use this law to manipulate everybody and do all these crazy things. You want to use this more in a positive way. That's what we're trying to do right now, is trying to give you more positive aspects of this law. Because some people will, I know people will take this law and take it to a literal standpoint and try to use this in a negative way. We want to influence more of a positive outlook, because life in a positive way makes everything better. It makes it better for not just yourself, but for everyone around you. And you don't want negativity to come in. You want to push that out, and you want to eradicate negativity and you want to push out positivity. You want to influence and inject positivity in everyone around you, including yourself. So that's what we're trying to do here with this law, and try to tell you to use this law in a positive way, but understand how it can be used negatively so you don't lose to it.
So with that said, if you have any comments on this law, leave them in the comment below. I hope the algorithm also like the video with the like button and subscribe to the channel as well for more content. We got a lot of good stuff coming out for you guys. Stay tuned. We'll see you in the next video.